business, motivational speaker, and thought leader, Kevin Liles.
I did all that. No, God is good. God is good. God is good. Amen. I'm not going to preach, but listen. I have to thank him, though, because I woke up this morning. Some people take breathing for granted. Some people take seeing for granted. Some people take graduating for granted. God is good. My God is good. So thank you, VP Holloman, President Myers, Jackson State faculty, graduates, family, loved ones. Good morning, and thank you for having me today. Now, in my life, I held many titles: student, classmate, intern, homeboy, president, CEO, founder, but it's all been one role to me. I was given life to help people live their life. Now, let's talk about dreams. You're at an inflection point today. Some place that I stood, some place that your parents stood, some place that faculty and staff have stood. Today feels accomplished, but I'm gonna tell you, your journey is just beginning. As you start this new journey, let's begin by discussing the possibilities versus the impossibilities. If you had time to turn on your TV today, Google, research, YouTube, somebody said, told you about the wrongs, the problems, the disease, et cetera, et cetera. New York Times tells us that 1.5 million black men in America are missing, in jail or dead. Washington Post tells us only 2% of African Americans are employed by Google or Yahoo, 1.5% by Facebook. African Americans are 12% of the US population, but only 4% of STEM degrees. But only 4% of STEM degrees. Someone may even told you today, dream big, but play it safe. Manage your expectations. Get a job and get benefits. Someone might have said, not you, you can't do it. Well, not today, because I'm at Jackson State, and Tigers, we challenge minds and change lives. I'm not here to talk about impossibilities, because you have possibilities. You have a choice. Let's talk about changing the headline. Change the headline, let's break the cycle. We are Tigers, we make it happen. On three, I need you to say make it happen. One, two, three. Yeah. One, two, three. Yeah. The first step isn't sexy, you can't shimmy to it. It's easy, but it's not easy, but it's essential. To me, you have to embrace the struggle. Folks ask me every day, Kev, how can you do it, how you do it? Oh, I wanna do this, I wanna rap, I wanna sing, I wanna be next to Jay-Z. Oh, Trey Songz, oh, whoop, yep. They hang and wanna do all this every day. And I say, stop trying to be somebody else. The secret to success is to do you and be you. That's the secret to success. Challenge the status quo. Ask the question, why and why not? Why did you do it that way? Why can't we do it this way? Folks say to me, Kev, you know, how did you do it? Well, one thing I did very early on in my life, I prepared myself for the opportunity. Opportunity wasn't gonna pass me by. It's no way opportunity wasn't gonna, I pulled my pants up as I got older. I stood up taller. I put a suit and a tie on. I said, opportunity, you will not pass me by. In failures, lie opportunity. Come up short, learn to grow tall. Not hurdles from A to B, you see hurdles? Struggles are teachers too. You must embrace it. Not simply survive it, but strive to be alive. Some people walk around every day just living life. Oh, I'm chilling. Oh, I'm here, I'm cooling. I don't believe any of that. You know, a closed door to me, a no to me is a catalyst for me to find my way. Find your way. And in the remix of my client's new hit, Baby, Won't You Come My Way? Yes, I have something to say. At Jackson State, we don't play. But first, think of something you say in this. Hey. Embracing, I can't sing. I don't claim to do that. Embracing the struggle develops critical skills, experience, and perspective for your life. Learn humility, but learn resilience. Learn hustle. You can read it in a book, but to understand it, you have to live it. You know, it's crucial to me that, and I want you to really believe this, that if you have it in your will, if it's your passion, you truly can shape your reality. Now, I was born in Baltimore, Maryland. Y'all heard about the stories, the wire, the corner, the riots, the this. So at 16, we're supposed to be dead on drugs or in jail. I took that statistic and turned it into a success story. I'm still alive, and my grandmother's street that I grew up on is named after me, Kevin Liles Drive. I don't take this for granted. My God is good, but I prepared myself for opportunity. My parents, my grandparents, God's grace, my community, they raised me. I didn't raise myself. I didn't do this myself. You didn't graduate yourself. You didn't wake up this morning by yourself. God put his hand over you and said, wake up, my child. Wake up, my child. You got work to do. You have to prepare yourself for opportunity. When it comes to things I control in my life, nothing is more important than my mindset. My mindset, not what I have on, not even how I smell, although I smell cool, you know. So. But it's not just about your talent or your charisma, it's about your mindset. My mindset told me, I will make it happen. I will be successful. And Malcolm X said, by any means necessary. I have a mindset. I will make it happen. I will be successful by any means necessary. In my experience through life, a lot of my friends, I find four things that I always say. Invest in relationships. Spend the time to go past the high. Ask somebody, how's your day? How's your family? Get to know them. Invest in relationships. Number two, I believe there's good work by believing in God and being kind. Be kind. Treat people like you want to be treated. There's good and bad or right or wrong. I don't care what religion. I don't care what book you read. Treat people like you want to be treated. Number three, and I was speaking to Dr. Myers about this, I said, do people remember where they come from? When they graduate from Jackson State and they're an alum, do they come back and give back? Well, I did it to my old high school. They said they needed a stadium. I haven't played football since I was in 10th grade. I built a stadium and track and field, not because I had to. It's because I had to remember my roots, because I once ran on that field. I once walked across that field. You have to remember where you came from. And number four, always give back. I can tell you that with success comes responsibility, not only to yourself, but to your family, your community, to your country. You have to give back. Listen, one of the things that I was able to go from intern to president, because no job was ever too small for me. I don't care what it was. You wanted me to get coffee? I'm going to make the best coffee. You see trash? Clean it up. The boss got in at 8 o'clock. I asked myself, now if he's the chairman and he's here at 8, I have to come in at 7. I have to prove to him that he don't have to come at 8. But the funny thing about my boss, I came in at 7, he came in at 6:30 the next day. You know, if I leave you with anything today, it's not to sell yourself short. You are Generation E. Advances in technology are unprecedented, and opportunity is endless now. You know, global shift is happening right in front of us. You know, the shift is so big, I haven't seen anything like this or read anything about this since the Industrial Revolution. You're not just reading a book now. You're writing the book. You're not just working at Apple or looking for a job. You want to build Apple and you want to create the new Apple. You're not just employed by an oil refinery. You want to own the oil refinery. Your generation is already reaching greatness. You know, today, because of their mindset, 17 years old, his name is Nick Dell'Osso. He sold his iPhone app, Sumly, to Yahoo for $30 million. At 17. Mindset. The Collison brothers, age 26 and 24, founded payment startup Stripe, valued today at $3.6 billion. Ask yourself, what's your dream? Challenge minds and changing lives. Do it. Live it. 17, 24, 26. Now, there are some people skeptical of our generation, but I disagree. I say we're Generation E, for education first, entrepreneurship second, and empowerment third. Generation primed to rewrite the world. Not their world, but your world. Impossibilities are no longer there. It's all about the possibilities, but get your mind right. One thing I ask, never lose touch and share humanity between each other. Tech, it might be the means, but it's not the end. Pick up the phone and say hello. Shake a hand, look them in the eye, hug them, tell them you love them. Let's not lose humanity. That's why I have to sit and say the motto about challenging minds and changing lives. I challenge your mind today to change somebody else's lives, somebody else's life, not just yours. I challenge your mind to wake up every day and say, how can I be of assistance? How can I be of service, dear Lord? How can I help the one next to me? How can I teach that kid to do something that maybe I couldn't do, but we laid the foundation for him to do it? Bring that motto everywhere you go. Learning doesn't stop when you cross the stage today. The great challenges of our time and need for the students of JSU in America, heal our cities, fight income and inequality, protect the environment. There should be a war on lack of education. There should be a war on poverty. Here in America, these things we have to fight together, and hopefully you graduates, you do that today. Believe that we can change the world together. And I came on campus and I saw all these flags around, and I said, Justin, what are the flags for? He said, Kevin, that's the circle of humanity. I said, Jesus, the circle of humanity? Had to take a picture. I know the globe is not there yet, but I had to take an Instagram picture because it made me say, the four walls of Jackson State doesn't define a person. The world, your travels, your experiences define you. Get to know the world. Get to know the world. You know, what it seems like to me, and it's a tall order, but legacies are built brick by brick. Starting today, the way you live your life will determine your greatness. It's your choice. Starting today, commit yourself to challenging minds and changing lives. Come back and give back. Your dreams are not limited here. You can achieve anything. And I tell you, please, dream big, but work hard on that dream every day. On three, make it happen. One, two, three. One, two, three. God bless you. God bless hip hop, and God bless America.